Move out.
If I'm late for muster one more time, Captain Kells is gonna have me do 100 push-ups.
It's good to see you again, Knight. You've come a long way since you stumbled into the Cambridge police station.
How've things been over there?
Pretty well, actually. We've had the occasional synth attack, but so far we've been able to keep them from overrunning us. Thanks to the reinforcements and the air support, I'd say that site was secure.
What about those feral ghouls? They still a problem?
With a vertebrate at our disposal? Not a chance. Anyway, I know you don't have time for small talk, so I'll get right to it. I've had the men set up the equipment we'll need to pinpoint you once you've found the bombs. We've rigged up this distress pulser to emit a unique tone that we'll be listening for. When you find the bombs, plant the pulser, and we'll handle the rest. After that, you should probably head back to Proctor Ingram and bring her your report.
Why use this distress pulser?
Unless you could locate an entire radio station within the glowing sea, there's no way you're going to be able to send out a regular signal. Luckily, the distress pulser's ping cuts right through the interference, and we'll be able to hear you as long as we stay close to the frontier. Look, I know you've been through the glowing sea before, but remember to keep an eye on your Geiger counter. If you don't, the radiation will cook you from the inside out. Good luck, Knight. Carry food with you, and you'll end up eating some pretty questionable things to stay alive.
anything behind.
Bucky, if you guys can hear me, stop messing around and come get me. Oh, I'm stuck in that shithole in the middle of the glowing sea. Wish I could give you a better idea. Remember that church steeple sticking out that we spotted a week ago? Go there.
Approaching Boston from the west, we've got heavy winds, but it shouldn't be a problem. Lining up for runway 2 at heading... What the hell is that? Some kind of bright light from the north!
What the...
Roger.